And the title of my dissertation is Implementing a Procedural Audio System Within a Video Game to Explore the Effects on a User's Experience. Create a system that was capable of producing audio in real time in a progressive and generating sense, and implement that alongside video game to look at how that affects a user experience when tested against a game that implements a more traditionally generated soundtrack. So from my literature review, I was able to look at methods of creating procedurally generated audio. This is in the form of different types of algorithms, different types of generative patterns. And from that, I was able to decide what I would implement within mine. I was also able to look at previous applications of procedural generation within video games, and also understand why video game companies are slightly lacking its adoption within their productions. Many of them favour traditional digital recording audio. So to prove my hypothesis, I used the Unity game engine, and I was able to develop a video game prototype, to say, it's written in C#. I used Max MSP, which is a kind of visual signal processing software. And using that, I was able to produce a generative audio system that communicates with the game engine over a local network link. And from that, I can take the parameters from the video game, say in-game events. So for example, a player visits a certain area. And when that occurs, see it would trigger a change or adaption within the audio system.
That was really good.
I had my procedural audio system running in the background, and with the other version I just used pre-recorded audio, a pre-recorded soundtrack, and I tested users, they gave me feedback when playing both versions of the game, and from that I was able to discover their preferences towards procedural audio, or whether they preferred the traditional method. So from my project, I created a prototype for a video game, and that is quite a simple concept as it is at the moment, so there is room for expansion on that idea. I also have a procedural audio system, which can be used as a standalone, or obviously it's got that direct communication link between the Unity game engine. My testing results showed that a lot of the people that I tested the two versions with, the majority of them, I think it was only one person, said they preferred the more traditional methods, and the majority preferred the audio system that did implement procedural audio generation. I think the most enjoyable thing about my dissertation that I completed was learning how to develop a video game, or a prototype for a video game, and actually establishing the communication link to the audio engine, which was quite a challenge for me, and it took quite a bit of time in getting that working and able to receive data was a major breakthrough for my project, and it allowed me to continue it.